Rainfall, humidity, temperature, the risk of flood and drought. This is the information farmers need to know. Forecasters don't take into account how evaporation affects the amount of water absorbed by the ground. Now, researchers at the University of Missouri have created a system that improves rain forecasts by accounting for evaporation in rainfall.
It's important to know exactly how much of the rain we observe reaches the ground, because that's the stuff that's important. That's the stuff that will get absorbed by the soil and used later for crops.
The size of a raindrop, however big or small, is a good indicator of the amount of rain that will fall. Atmospheric science professor Neil Fox uses radar to more accurately determine the size of a raindrop.
What's great about this radar is that it's what's called a dual-polarization radar, which means it actually sends out two beams, one which measures how big the raindrops are vertically and how big they are horizontally, which tells us about the shape of the drops. And as different size raindrops are different shapes, we can actually then get a much more accurate measure of how many drops there are of each size.
Big raindrops don't evaporate as quickly as small ones, so more big drops in the air means it's more likely to rain. They developed a method that tracks raindrops from cloud to ground, determining how much evaporation would occur.
It sends out basically microwave radiation, really try and measure how many drops of each size there are when they fall from the cloud toward the surface. Because if the air is dry towards the surface, the different size drops will evaporate at different rates.
Fox says accurate rainfall estimates also make for better weather forecasts in general, which can be helpful for predicting storms and other weather emergencies like floods. He says farmers might benefit the most, as accurate forecasts can minimize crop damage and save time and money on irrigation.
So if you're planning, say, irrigation or planting, and you don't know exactly how much water has reached the soil, you're going to get that wrong, and it could cost quite a lot of money.
He says the improvement in forecast prediction accuracy is significant, especially in areas more than 30 miles from the nearest National Weather Service radar station. For HEC, I'm Kathleen Berger.